So the expanded gun background check bill went down in the U.S. Senate. 54 voted for it, while 46 voted against it. And in the Senate, you need to have at least 60 votes to get past the filibuster. So here is a list of all of the Republicans who broke ranks and voted for it. And here is a list of all the Democrats who broke ranks to go against it. Hey guys, it's April 17th, 2013. I'm Reginald, I'm also known as Democad. First, the Boston bombing, a little update on that. Over 100 people were injured. 3 people have died because of that bombing. Looks like the bomber put some type of pressure cooker in. He made a bomb out of a pressure cooker and possibly used a cell phone to set off his bombs in a trash can. And at this point, we don't really have a lot of information. CNN and some other networks were reporting that there was an arrest, and the FBI said that's not true. So it looks like there's really no suspects. There's some rumors about a Saudi national as a suspect or as a person of interest, and that turned out to be untrue. The New York Post was posting some stuff. Their claims were off, to say the least. And, you know, the FBI warned that these media outlets have to be careful about the stuff they're putting out there. And I warned people about that last night on Facebook. You know, we got to be extra careful about the information we're putting out there, because there's a lot of false information whenever something like this happens, so we got to be extra careful. But anyway, news stories. Okay, industrial output, it was actually up 0.4%, which is a little good news there in the economy. It was actually fueled by utilities in recent months, so it's a little good news there. According to the Environmental Working Group, they use government tests. And they found that when you look at the government tests, the amount of raw foods in grocery stores with antibiotic resistance. I'm talking antibiotic resistant bacteria in the food. What is the percentage of it? Well, here it is right here, according to this test. Was as high as 81% in ground turkey, 81% in ground turkey, 69% in pork chop, 55% in ground beef, and 39% in chicken. So what this means is that the overuse of antibiotics in animals and people, it has its consequences. So at this point, we can pretty much expect that in the future we're going to be dealing with more antibiotic resistance, even when it comes to the cows and things like that, and even when it comes to people, because it's been misused for quite a time. So, okay, the Stock Act, that's something I wanted to talk about. Congress passed something called the Stock Act, and it was actually designed to stop trading with congressional knowledge. That's what it's called. Basically stop insider trading among high U.S. officials, especially Congress members. But I think it was a weak act to begin with. But recently, they actually made a change. They wanted to, and this is unanimous, they made a change where they no longer have to post, it's no longer mandatory that they have to post this information on the internet. Okay, so their financial activities on the internet, they don't really have to post that anymore if this moves ahead. And it's sort of interesting. It's sort of a transparency issue right here. But ultimately, you know, money moves this planet. You know, it all comes down to the money. I hate to say it, but, you know, that's what gets people going. Money. Opium. Speaking of money, okay. Opium production in Afghanistan continues to go up. And they actually hit it at the highest since 2008. Obviously, we had soldiers and we have a war going on over there. When we came in there, it didn't stop the opium production. It actually increased. And 75% of the world's heroin actually comes from that region, which is absolutely incredible. You know, again, I wouldn't be for criminalizing the use of drugs. Frankly, I think people should have that choice. If they want to use certain drugs, hey, you know, it's their body. They should live with the consequences. I don't think we should be paying tax dollars to really put people in prison for dealing that crap. People are going to do what they're going to do anyway. Okay, Remington, speaking of money, Remington, they're going to sign an $80 million contract, according to Congressman Hanna. Remington is in New York, and of course, New York passed this really tough anti-gun law. Well, for the next 10 years, they're going to be manufacturing rifle guns, sniper rifles, in the state of New York for the U.S. government. So, you know, they're not going anywhere, despite New York. The state of New York's anti-gun push. They're not going anywhere. So, I mean, that's what it really comes down to, you know, the money, money, money. Question of the day. Do you think we're going to get to a point where antibiotics are so useless that we're going to be set up for a pandemic, on at least regarding humans? And do you think we're going to get to a point where we're not going to be able to get rid of the bacteria and the diseases out of a lot of these animals, because a lot of these animals are going to build up a resistance to it, and they may possibly contribute to an even bigger problem. So do you see the overuse or the misuse of antibiotics contributing to a plague or a much bigger problem in the future? All right, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.